I'm going to show you how partial indexes can make your queries way more efficient. They allow us to copy just a subset of the table rather than the entire thing, making it much faster for Postgres to find data and minimizing the amount of space it takes up on disk. So a quick recap on indexes generally. They store a copy of some data that Postgres knows how to search very, very quickly. Partial indexes take this a step further by only copying the values that meet a conditional expression, in this case, only the active users. So let's build out this example and see if it works the way we expect. Here I have a people table, which has over 10 million records. But if I filter this down to just the people where the isActive column is equal to true and apply that filter, we'll see only a million of those records are actually active. So only about 10% of the table. So if we head over to the SQL editor and write a query to select the username from the people table where the username column is equal to the string John with an H. Weird spelling, I know, but it turns out there are a lot more of them than those much more unique Johns with no H. So we want to find all of those mutant Johns, but only where they also have the is underscore active column set to true. So only the active John users. Let's whack and explain analyze before this query so we can measure how long it takes to run. We'll just fix up our indenting there and run this query, and we can see it's taking a while. And if we time travel into the future, we can see it took about 17 seconds to complete, returning around 124 rows from our 10 million people. So let's make this much more efficient by indexing the username column. So let's go ahead and create an index on the people table, indexing the username column. And if we highlight just this one statement, we can run it on its own. And once that's finished, we can run this query to get all of the active Johns again. And we can see this is significantly faster, but it's still taking almost a second to complete. So we know that an index is just a copy of some data. And we also know that 90% of the rows in the people table are for deactivated accounts, which our query is just filtering out anyway. So can we just store the active accounts in our index and create kind of like a partial subset of our table? Yes, we can. So we'll keep the username index we created earlier so we can do some comparing, but let's create another index on the people table, copying the username column, but only where the is underscore active column is equal to true. And let's run this one to create our partial index. And once that's finished, we can run our query again to get all of those active John users. And we can see this has taken a fraction of the time at 1 millisecond, so almost 1/1000th of how long it took for our original bloated index that unnecessarily contained all of those deactivated accounts. We could even remove the bit that's looking for a specific user. So now we're just selecting all of the people who have active accounts, but our index is only storing that username column. So since we're no longer filtering by username, is Postgres going to use our index, or is it going to do a full sequential scan of the people table? Well, what do you think? Well, the only way to truly know is to run the query. And I've got a syntax error because I left in that and got rid of the where. So we want to just select all of the usernames of the people where their accounts are active. And let's run this one. And we can see Postgres was smart enough to do an index only scan on our partial index for username because it knew that that would be faster than a full sequential table scan. And this only took 500 milliseconds to return the usernames of nearly a million records. That's insane. And it's like one very simple line of SQL. So how much space do each of these indexes take up on disk? I'm going to guess that maybe the partial index is a little bit smaller. Well, if we dump in this very intimidating query that I copied from Google and give it a run, we can see each of our indexes and the amount of space they take up. Ignore this first one. It's automatically created by Postgres to manage the primary key for each of our tables. But we can see our original username index is 71 meg and our partial index of just active accounts is 7,336 meg. That doesn't seem right. Oh wait, that's kilobytes, as in 7 megabytes. So like 10% of the size of our regular username index that stores all of those deactivated accounts. Well, that checks out because we're only storing about 10% of the people table once we eliminate all of those deactivated accounts. So partial indexes work really well for Boolean columns, like if an account is active or not, or whether a blog post has been published, basically anywhere where the columns contain a lot of null values or data that's irrelevant to our queries that can easily be excluded from the index. Now, the next logical step is to think, great, let's just segment up our data into a bunch of partial indexes, making each one of them super small and really fast for Postgres to search. A more concrete example of this would be a multi-tenant database where tables are shared across multiple users. This is just a simple to-do list app, but you can imagine any application where data is restricted to particular users, or you just have clear segmentation of data that you know there's no overlap. So we could create an index on the to-do table, maybe indexing the title column, but only where the owner is equal to John. And then we could create another index where the owner is Tyler and another one where the owner is Thor. But while this might make sense in your brain, it will confuse the heck out of Postgres and it needs to do a bunch more work to determine which index it should use. A similar example of this is actually called out in the docs where you have a bunch of different categories that are non-overlapping. The reason this is a problem is that Postgres doesn't understand the relationship between these different partial indexes, so it needs to test each one to determine the most efficient path. But this data is so perfectly segmented. There has to be a way to chunk it up into logical partitions. Well, there is, but for that, you need to check out this video right here. We use table partitions to tell Postgres how to logically segment our data, making those massive shared tables much more efficient to query. And if you just want to keep learning a little bit more about Postgres, check out this playlist. But until next time, keep building cool stuff.